Hello, I'm Stephen Pratchner from the PIX team at Microsoft. This is the fourth in a series of videos introducing you to PIX, the Microsoft game-focused profiling tool for Windows and Xbox games. In this video, I'll go through the steps that are required to analyze CPU samples in PIX Timing Captures. Game developers are likely familiar with a common performance problem seen in games, an unexpected drop in frame rate. These drops occur when a frame takes longer to execute than is expected. Common causes of these drops in frame rate from a CPU perspective include using inefficient algorithms, having dependencies between threads, and performing too many expensive operations during a frame, such as allocating memory or reading from files. In this video, I'll use the CPU sampling features in PIX Timing Captures to diagnose a spike in frame time that is caused by performing expensive operations during a frame. These CPU sampling features are particularly useful in cases where a game has insufficient instrumentation in the form of PIX events to help you diagnose a performance problem, as we'll see in a bit. To capture CPU samples, select the CPU Samples checkbox before starting a timing capture. PIX captures a call stack of the code that is running at various time intervals, as specified by a sampling rate. Use the drop-down list to the right to select from one of three predefined sampling rates: low impact, balanced, and maximum data. Selecting the low impact rate has minimal impact on your game, but doesn't give you much precision. Selecting the maximum data rate gives you more precision at the cost of higher overhead. Selecting the balanced rate gives you a compromise between the low impact and maximum data settings. Depending on the scenario, you might make this precision trade-off differently. Let's switch now to a timing capture that I have taken. Look at this long frame running on the thread named app main. When looking at the duration of this main loop event, it's easy to see that this frame takes significantly longer to run than the frames before it or after it. The primary difference between the long frame and the frames on either side of it is the presence of the update enemy positions event. It isn't present in the other frames, or its duration is so short in those frames that it doesn't appear unless I zoom in further. When we look at the update enemy positions event, there are no additional PIX events that are nested underneath the event that we can use to get more detail. Also, looking across this event, code is running the entire time. There are no stalls, so we can eliminate a dependency between threads as the cause of this spike in frame time. As it stands, we don't have any additional information to help us diagnose this spike. This is where CPU samples come in. Recall that when samples are collected, PIX captures a call stack of the code that was running at the time interval specified by the sampling rate. One way to view these call stacks is in a flame graph that is drawn just under the PIX events. I'm going to select the threads with call stack configuration and then select Apply to display the flame graph. Next, I'm going to zoom in until I can see enough detail to help determine the cause of our spike. By zooming in far enough, I start to see calls to the new operator, indicating that memory is being allocated during this frame. Avoid this because memory allocations are a relatively expensive operation. Using the flame graph, I've identified that memory is being allocated, but there are still a few more questions I'd like to answer. How frequently am I allocating memory? How expensive is it? Where in my game are these allocations occurring? To answer these questions, I want to analyze all the samples that were collected during update enemy positions as a group. To do so, I'll select the event and then select Use Selected Event from the Time Range drop-down list to populate the Range Details view with data from the time that the event ran. I then select Sampled Functions from the Items to Show drop-down. PIX has now analyzed the CPU samples that were collected in our time range and has aggregated them into a single stack tree. But because I want to look at the samples only from the app main thread, I'll use this Display Options panel to group our stack tree by thread. I'll explore the tree for the app main thread until I find the update enemy positions event. Here it is. And by expanding one more level to see what update enemy positions is calling, I start to better understand the scope of the problem. First, I can see that the new operator is being called 23 times. There are clearly lots of memory allocations happening in the middle of this frame, and it gets worse. If I expand this node above, representing a vector, I can see that manipulating this vector is also calling operator new to allocate memory. I found that several memory allocations are occurring during the long frame. We need to discover where in the update enemy positions function these allocations are happening. I'll select the update enemy positions function again, and then select the source analysis tab in the element details view to the left. The C++ source code for my function is displayed, and by scrolling down, these lines highlighted in red pinpoint the exact source code lines that are allocating memory. And sure enough, it's the manipulation of the vector that is causing our performance issue. I can now go into my game's source code to fix the issue. In this video, I've used the CPU samples analysis features in PIX Timing Captures to diagnose a frame that ran long because it was performing expensive memory allocation operations during that frame. In the next video, I'll introduce the metrics view, which is a graphical analysis tool in PIX Timing Captures used to diagnose a variety of performance issues. Thank you for watching.